What's up, everybody? Day number eight. Hope you're having a wonderful weekend so far. But we're at day number eight of the 10 reasons why you should have a home-based business. It's Janet Green back again. And I want to share with you, have you ever heard this saying right here? You've heard this on television. You're fired. You guys remember that? Remember Donald Trump used to have that little thingy. I don't know what, it's not a sitcom, but it was a program that he had called The Apprentice. And one of the things that everybody remembers about The Apprentice is the fact that he said to the person that did not work out well for the show or for the job or whatever it was that he was able to fire them. Why was he able to fire them? He was able to fire them because he was calling the shots. Well, what if you could walk into your boss's office in the next 6 months and say, "You're fired"? Would that be an amazing feeling to be able to say that to your boss? It doesn't matter. You know, you could have been working there for 15 or 20 years, and to be able to have established a home-based business such that it was the income from the home-based business was equaling out or exceeding your regular salary, so that you can actually walk away from your job. Wouldn't that be amazing? Well, that is a key reason why you should have a home-based business, because unless you just plan to work until you retire or you're 75, you know, people are not retiring very early these days. People are working for a very long, long time. And if you're not the individual that wants to work for somebody for a long, long time, then you need to be putting in place a home-based business. Now, we talked about a whole lot of other reasons. And when I get ready to finish this up, probably tomorrow, I'm going to come back and do that huge review over all of those reasons, because I want you to be thinking about this. If it's been a dream of yours, if you've been afraid to take the step, I'm going to encourage you to just think about what it would feel like to be able to walk into your boss's office and tell him that he's actually fired, that you no longer need his check. The check that was never really enough anyway, the check that never really paid you based on your worth, even though you agreed to work for that amount per month because it paid the bills, it never really paid you what you're worth. And while I'm at that station, I want you to know that there's probably not a job anywhere that will pay you what you're worth. So once you're able to walk in there and fire your boss, guess what's going to happen? The ceiling on your salary is going to be lifted. As a matter of fact, it will just go away, because there will be nobody determining how much you're worth per hour, per month, per year, per task, or whatever it is. There will be nobody deciding that but you. What an amazing feeling. So if you could just walk with me just for a few seconds and just sense, feel, think about what it would be like knowing that you could fire your boss, take all of the limitations off of your salary, open up, walk into a place where all possibilities were laid out before you. And now, because you don't have the boss telling you what to do, you can kind of do things the way you are led, the way you feel led to get them done. The other benefit to firing your boss is this: he no longer can tell you what time you have to start work. He no longer can tell you what time you go on your lunch break. He no longer can tell you how long your lunch break is. He no longer can tell you when you can take a vacation. So when you fire your boss, you open up all kinds of control over your own life. Wow. So to me, that is huge, to be able to fire your boss. I just want you to think about it, okay? I didn't plan to stay on here very long, but I really want you to consider the benefits. Now, the other thing with firing your boss, now you are in control. Now, there's some, you know, now you got to work through. Nobody's telling me when to get up, so you got to get up on your own. Nobody's telling you how many hours you have to work, so you have to set your own work hours and those kinds of things. But just to have the freedom to do it and to know that what you're doing is going to be more than adequate to take care of you and your family. That is an amazing feeling. All right. That's my day number 8 for you. And I want you to come back and catch me on tomorrow night or tomorrow evening. And we're going to finish out this series. I'll probably give you the last 2 on tomorrow instead of going into 10 days. We'll do the last 2 tomorrow. And then I'll also do the review just in case you've missed some of these days. Now, if you have, if you're on my Facebook page or if you are on YouTube, you'll be able to go to my channel. And that's what, you know, I want you to like my channel, subscribe to my channel so you can be able to go to the channel, go through all of the days and just enjoy the value, the content that I've given to you over the last several days and the other stuff that's out there. Okay, so that's my day number 8 for you, and I'll look forward to seeing you on tomorrow. Have a good night.